What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. In the last video of this series, we discussed and implemented tries, also known as prefix trees. However, if you've watched this previous video, you may have noticed that tries aren't really memory efficient, as each node contains a map of nodes, and this map may contain an unlimited number of children. Ternary search trees are a special type of tries that improve on this issue by limiting the number of children a node can have to 3 children only, a left, a right, and a middle child. Additionally, like other prefix trees, ternary search trees can be used as an associative map structure or to search for a particular string inside it, which is mainly useful in applications like spell checking and autocompletion. The first difference to note between standard prefix trees and ternary search trees is the root node. It doesn't need to be an empty string. You can start inserting your words into the tree right away. And the second difference is that this tree is a search tree, and like binary search trees, the left children of a certain node are smaller than this node, and the right children of a specific node are greater than this node. Now, suppose we have this tree, which already contains a couple words, and let's try to insert into it a couple more. The character L of the word like is greater than the root, therefore we will need to go to the right, and that is where this word will sit. The following characters of this word will be linked using the middle child. But if we take the word geekific, let's say, you will see that the first 4 letters, or geek, are already present in the tree. However, the middle child of K is an S. Therefore, and because the I is smaller alphabetically than the character S, and because I does not belong to the same word that geeks belongs to, the remaining letters of the word geekific will be linked to the tree with the help of the left child of the node S. Okay, now that we have a few words inside the tree, how do we search for these words? Or for a specific value associated with a word if we were using this tree as a map? Searching inside a ternary search tree is super easy. It is actually very similar to searching in a binary search tree. Given a word, we start at the root, and if the character at hand is smaller, we go left. If bigger, we go right. If equal, we keep going straight in the middle. If we reach a leaf node or a null node without having found the word, then this word does not exist in the tree. The last operation we are going to discuss is the delete operation. Now, because in the last video we explained and implemented how a given word is removed from a standard prefix tree, in this video we are going to discuss and implement the soft delete operation. What this operation will do is remove the value associated with a given word inside the tree if this tree is used as a map, or remove the end of word mark from this word without actually removing the word from the tree. You see, this approach is actually more implemented with ternary search trees rather than standard prefix trees, because back then we needed to save as much memory as possible to avoid having a lot of children tied to the same node. However, here we don't really have this problem. But hey, if you want to actually delete the word from the tree, no one is going to prevent you. Okay, with that said, let's go ahead now and try to implement all of the operations we discussed, and let's start with the node class as usual. This class is very similar to the one we implemented in the last video. However, instead of having a map or a list of nodes as children, we are going to have only 3 children, a left, a right, and a middle one. I also went ahead and added a helper method to help us identify if this node marks the end of a word or if it doesn't. In our case, we will be using the ternary search tree as a map. That is why the check is made on the value stored inside the node. This value was also generified, allowing us to store any type of objects inside the map. Additionally, a few Lombok annotations were used, which will save us the pain of generating setters, getters, and all of this boilerplate code. Now, let's take a look at the interface we are going to implement. As you can see, these are the exact operations we've been discussing during the video, the insert, search, and delete operations. In addition to these, I added the get method, which will retrieve the value tied to a given word or key in the map. Okay, before starting with the insert method, the last thing I want to mention is the actual ternary search tree class. On top of generifying this class and making it implement the tree interface we just saw, it should also store a reference to the root node of the tree, just like any other tree we implemented. Okay, now on to the insert method. The main method, or the one exposed to the interface, will be a very concise one, as all it does is calling another method, the recursive method, where all the magic happens. In addition to a node, the word we want to insert, and a value, this method takes an index as parameter to keep track of the characters belonging to the word we are currently working with. Now, as we previously mentioned, we have to check if the character we are currently iterating over is smaller than the node at hand, then we go left. If it is bigger, we go right. If none of these conditions are satisfied, it means that the character is equal to the one present in the tree, or that we need to create a new node for it. How do we distinguish both cases? Well, no need, as whatever the case is, we will be using the middle node, and we will keep doing that until our index reaches the length of the word, which means that the whole word is already present or was inserted in the tree. All we have to do at this point is add the value we want to the corresponding node we reached. Now, to loop over and find the nodes, what we did was used heavily recursive calls. If you are not familiar with these, you can check our binary search tree video, linked down below in the description, where we explain in detail how these calls work and what is the logic behind implementing them. A small note here is that the index was only incremented for the middle node, because in this case, the character was found, or a new node was inserted for it, so the iteration over the characters of the word must proceed to the next one. However, in case of the left and right children, nothing matched. Nothing was created. We are still trying to find the character at hand until we reach a null node. Once a null node is reached, a new node for the current index will be created. And from here on, only middle nodes will be used. Okay, I hope the explanation of the insert operation was clear, because all of the remaining operations will be very similar to this one. So, concerning the contains method, what this one will do is call the search recursive method, which, as I just said, is very similar to the insert one, but instead of inserting values and updating nodes, what this method will do is iterate over the tree in search of a particular sequence of characters, and as soon as null node is hit, the null value is returned. However, if the word is present inside the tree and the recursive calls manage to traverse all the middle nodes all the way till they reach the last node of this word, then this node is returned to the initial method, which checks if it is an end-of-word node. And if it is, it returns true. Another very similar method to this one is the get method. This method will make use of the same search recursive call, but the difference is that at the end, instead of just returning a boolean to the user to inform them if the tree contains the word, it will return the actual value corresponding to that word inside the map. The last method we are going to implement is the softDelete operation. Similarly to the operations we just implemented, the method exposed by the interface will only call the delete recursive method. This recursive method will use the exact same conditions used by the insert one, so we will loop over the characters of the given word, and if the character at hand is smaller, we go left, if bigger, we go right, if none of these apply, and we still haven't reached the end of the word, we use the middle node. However, what differs is when we do indeed find the last node corresponding to the word to delete, which is the node storing the value associated with that word. So, what we have to do is remove this value by setting it to null, and boom, the soft delete operation is now complete. Now, before ending the video, I want us to visualize and test this implementation together. To do that, I created a main class and inserted a bunch of words into the tree. If you are familiar with the tree view class, or if you've watched our tree's visualization video, you may recognize the piece of code we just added. When we run it, we are going to obtain the tree you see in front of you, which clearly displays how the elements alongside their values are being inserted inside a ternary search tree. Finally, if you try to delete a string from the tree and rerun the code, you will see that the value associated to the word in question was indeed removed from the tree map we have correctly. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I'll see you in the next one.